Trello calendar is a useful feature to have on your Trello boards if you are a regular user of Trello project management application. Today I will show you two power-ups which you can use to achieve the calendar functionality in your Trello boards. Now, first you need to understand the importance of having a calendar. So these are my lists. These are three generic lists for a project manager: what to do, what we are currently doing, and what we have done. Now, in this list I have these cards, and every card might have one or more tasks, and some cards, as you can see, they have a due date. Now, the problem with having only the due date is that it is kind of random dates, and this happens in project management. Sometimes you have to start a task which is going to finish later, but you have to start it earlier, and the vice versa. In calendar, we will be able to see all those tasks which need our attention today or within next 3 days or within a week or a month. So this is why we use calendar, so that we can see what is due next. Now, there are two power-ups which you can use to get calendar functionality. So I will demonstrate both of them. But if you are on a free Trello plan, you can check only one power-up at a time. So you can do that easily, and I will show you how. So let's start. Click on Show menu, and in this power-ups, because Trello gave me 1 month free gold membership, so therefore I can add 3 power-ups at the moment. So I just click Add power-up, and now the first power-up is the default calendar power-up. So I just type calendar. Then this is the power-up which we are going to demonstrate first. And then the second power-up is Planyway calendar. So these two we are going to see today. So first click on Add, and now we can close this window because we can see calendar here, and calendar has been added at the top of the board. Now if I click on calendar now, now I can see all my tasks on a calendar, and there are two views. One is the month view and the other is the week view. So if I click on week view, I have this card which is due in this week, and this is the current day which is shown in yellow color. So this card is due within 2 days. So I should be focusing on this task now. And if you select week, you can have some more information: what team members are working on this card at the moment, and that you are watching this card. Watching means that if anyone updates any information inside the card, you will get the notification. So this is how it works. If I select month, now I can see all the cards. These strike through cards represent those tasks which have been completed. Now I can see the picture more clearly. And the second advantage is, which is from the productivity point of view, that instead of changing the due date on a card, you can simply drag this card to the next date, and it will change. Now the due date on this card will change. So this is the way you can use calendar power-up to see the clear picture of your project and to be more productive by having the ability to drag and drop your cards from one date to another date. So these are the two main advantages of using calendar power-up. But there are few things which you cannot do here. For example, if you want to put a start and end date on this task, that it will start on 16th and it will end on, let's say, 24th. So this you cannot do on calendar power-up. So therefore, I want to demonstrate another power-up on which you can do this. And now let's close this, and I can add the other power-up. But let's say you are on a free Trello account and you want to remove this power-up because you are only allowed to have one power-up. You can click on this and then disable this. And now I have disabled the calendar power-up. And now I can add the new power-up. So I click on Add power-up. And the other power-up is Planyway. This is the power-up. Add. And now I can close this, because I can see the icon appearing here. And on the right-hand side, it also appears here. So I can close this. And now if I click on this Planyway planner, I can see my cards here. And now if I click on this, in Planyway I can see that every card has a start and an end date. Now this task has a start and end date because I have previously used this power-up. And now let's say I want to put a start and end date of this task. What I can do is I hover over this end. When this double-sided arrow appears, I click and drag. and then I release. And if I click on this, I can see that now it has a start date and an end date. Now, in order to use this Planyway planner power up, the best way it is to use with a Chrome extension. So I just type Planyway Chrome extension. And now if I click on this and then click on add to Chrome, this extension will be added, add extension. And now let me close these windows and I reopen this board. So it needs to be enabled. So I just click enabled. And now I allow this app to get access to a few things which are written here. You can read it if you like, allow. And now we have the view of our Trello board and this extension here. So this is a better way of working with Planyway. You can click on this Planyway and you can go back to your Trello board, or you can just click again and you can see both views. There are many other features in this power up, but those features are paid features. For example, these filters, these are very powerful, but when you try to apply these filters, you will see that it needs a pro version. Similarly, you can add boards. But as soon as you click on this and you try to add any other board, which would be very powerful because on one calendar, you would be able to see more than one projects, which is fantastic. But as soon as you try to click, it says it's a pro feature. Now there are two views. Currently I am in the calendar view, but you can also have a timeline view. So if I click on timeline, now you can see that there is some overlap between these tasks and when this task is just like a Gantt chart. So you can use this timeline feature, which is a very powerful feature as well. In particular, if you are working on any engineering project where still most project managers use Gantt charts, so this will be very useful for you. So timeline and calendar, two kinds of features we have here. If I click on this settings and then settings again, here I have the ability to link due date to either to start date or to the end date, or if I want, I do not link to any due date. So let's say I link this to end date. So the due date is the end date of any task, and then I can save this. And why due date is important? Because if you are watching this card, if you are assigned this card, then you will get the notification about your due date. So this is why due date is important. Another powerful functionality is synchronization with your Google Drive. And if I click on this, again, it's a pro feature. So if you want to synchronize your Google Drive with your Trello board, you can think about paying this company, I think $5 a month. If these features are beneficial for you, you can go ahead and purchase this power up. So let's go back to calendar view. So I can also change this from month to day, and then I will get the time as well. Similarly, I can go for 3 days with the time, up to 1 week, I will get this time as well. So this is useful if you want to have a closer look on some of the tasks within a week, for example, any meeting at a specific time. Now let's set it back to monthly basis. And if you want more space, you can just drag this lower and you can get more space on any side wherever you want. Another pro feature is that if I want to see all my 3 lists here at the bottom, so that I can drag and drop cards from all of my lists. So to do that, I have to activate lists inside this filter. If I click on any of these lists, I can put these lists here so that I can drag and drop cards from those lists. But this is also a pro feature. If I click on this, it will show me that it is a pro feature. Now at the end, I would like to show you a few more features. If you click on this pencil icon, you have the ability to set the priority feature, but this is a paid feature, as you can see. However, this label feature, you can label these. For example, I can put a green label on that. And similarly, you can add any members to this card, and you can also mark it as complete, or you can duplicate or archive a card. And one important feature is that you can directly delete this card. And to remove this label, just click it again and it will be removed. So So this was a brief overview of these two power-ups, Calendar and Planyway, which you can use to have the calendar functionality on your Trello boards.